Hello, Thaddeus with Square One Fitness, and this is day 12 of the Body Transformation Series. Real quick, before we get started, I just wanted to give a quick shout out to Leo hashtag right here, Leo hashtag. Thank you very much for subscribing. It really does help. For everybody else, if you've been enjoying the videos, you're going to come back and watch another one, please subscribe. We're putting up a video every day of the body transformation and the body fat. Going to try and bulk up, put on a little muscle. So if you want to see that, or if you've been enjoying the videos at all, please go ahead and hit the like button and the subscribe button to see more. Now that we got that out of the way, it is day 12. That's me on day 12, 173 pounds, 173.1. Down a couple pounds from yesterday, but I do say every single day, not really into the weight, just mostly into losing this body fat. Anything I can squeeze, I kind of want to get rid of. Pack on a little muscle, sometime in the next, you know, doing that in the next 60 to 90 days. So again, not worried about weight, probably going to end up right around the same weight, 170-ish pounds, but hopefully be, you know, ripped. So I'm going to jump right into the video today, into the workout. Today we got back. We got biceps, the quote-unquote glamour muscles, according to Tony Horton and P90X. I do really enjoy this workout, though. I don't know why. I don't really like pull-ups, but for some reason, the pull-ups and the curls, pull-ups, curls, pull-ups, curls, I just really like that combination. So we're going to jump right in. Here we go. Oh, last thing. Pre-workout is C4. They sell that at Costco. It's really the only reason I'm drinking it right now is I was at Costco and I bought some. Pretty good though, gets me going. I'll probably try something different next time. And always stretch before your work. Probably one of my hardest pull-ups just to get my arms out wide like that. But we're going to go for, I think we did 10 last time, so we're going to go for 5 clean. So 5 while we're still under tension and then try and do 5 more. Maybe a couple bonus. Next, we're going to do a lawnmower. Sometimes we do them on a flat bench, and sometimes we do them standing, so just kind of switch it up a little bit. But pretty much all the same move. And I'm going to turn this heater off. Curls, so 21s. Go halfway up 7 times, start at halfway point, finish a curl 7 times, do 7 full curls. That's why they're called 21s. You could easily call them 30s and just do 10 of each. Anyway, just another variation of a curl. I really do like this workout again because they switch up the curls and the pull up so much. Really makes you feel like you're keeping it interesting. I don't know. I don't know if that's the right word. Anyway. 21's up next. Next set is called crossbody, so let's just start with a neutral grip, and we're just going to bring it right up and across. our body as we curl. So cross body curls, one at a time, one arm at a time. I do kind of like to start bringing the next one up right as soon as the, so as soon as this one starts to come down, I like to bring this one up. Concentric, eccentric motion, to use big fancy words, but basically it just keeps an arm under tension the entire time instead of just letting one hang out, if I can. Anyway, a lot of talking today. We're gonna go for 16 each arm. Pull-ups again. We're gonna do a flip grip, if you will, or a switch grip. So we're gonna go wide, narrow, reverse, and neutral, and do three of each, so 12 total. Here we go. Lawnmower, elbow out this time. So instead of kind of a neutral grip, we're gonna do a pronated grip, palm facing backwards. 45 pounds, trying to do 16 of these. We're trying to upping our weight a little bit today, so we'll see. Here we go. Next, we got just a good old-fashioned standing bicep curl. So we're gonna do a supinated grip, palms facing forward, nice strong through the core, soft knees, and just curling the weights. We're gonna use 30 pounds, 30-pound dumbbells. We got concentration curls. So any bench, you can even squat and do these with your, or sit and do them with your elbow tucked into your knee joint. But we got a bench here, so put the bench at a slight angle and do some curls. We're using 20-pound dumbbells. Here we go. Corn cob pull-ups. So I'm supposed to pull up and then go side to side. I understand you're supposed to be away from the bar a little bit too when you do that, so not like tucked in, but have your hands pushed out from the bar a little bit. So out. In my opinion, by far my worst pull-up. You know, I'm not great at pull-ups yet anyway. So having said that, you know, I can get myself up there, but the side to side is a little lacking. So still working on it. More than that, I noticed for several weeks in a row, I've been doing five. So we're gonna do six today. That's right. I don't care if they look ugly, we're gonna do one more of them. Here we go. We got a true compound movement. We're gonna do a reverse grip row. It really works well into today's exercise because we get to use our back for the row, but we also get to use our biceps because of the reverse grip. So, back and biceps all in one move. We're at 105 on the plates, and we're gonna try and do 16 of them. If we can do some bonus ones, it's time to go up in weight. So, here we go. All right, up next we got open arm curls. So instead of just fully supinating, we're still gonna have a supinated grip, but we're gonna bring the weights up into the side, almost like a side hammer curl, if you will. Anyway, we're gonna go for 16 of them with 30 pound weights, 30 pound dumbbells, and here we go. Really struggling with those today. Form was all ugly. Anyway, moving on. Alright, next we got static arm curls. So I'm gonna take a weight, bring it 45 degrees, forearm 45 degree angle, parallel to the ground. Other arm's gonna curl the weight. We're gonna do four times. We're gonna switch four times. We're gonna do that twice, so it's eight curls per arm. With a static arm during those eight. So anyway, you know what I'm trying to say anymore. Hopefully we'll be able to knock these out. We're feeling really weak with those last curls. So anyway, here we go. More pull-ups, towel pull-ups. Gonna get that over. One hand stays on the towel, one hand's pulling. We're gonna do a neutral grip for this one. I kinda switched up the towel pull-ups, the grip. So we're gonna do a neutral grip with towel pull-ups. We're gonna do three, switch the towel, do three, switch the towel. Try and do that to 12 pull-ups. 12 pull-ups seems to be about where I'm at right now. Anyway, here we go. Cable rows. We're gonna do a single grip. So we're gonna go one arm at a time, a neutral grip with one arm at a time. This originated with a Congdon row or something. I forget what P90X called these, but basically it was a one arm bent over row. So I just switched it up to the cable. Anyway, we're gonna try and do 20 per arm, 40 total. It's pretty aggressive, but we're gonna go for it. Here we go. All right, up next we got more curls. If you haven't ever seen one of these, this one is a Body Solid Built for Life. Body Solid, that's just the name of the company who built it. This is what I've heard referred to as an arm blaster or a bicep blaster. Basically, it goes around the body like so and just locks your arms in, almost making it like a concentration curl, but you can do both arms at the same time. So again, bicep blaster. Highly recommend one of these if you enjoy curls, if you're doing curls, if you want to fix your curls, if you want to better curls, if you just want to make them harder. This sucker works great. Plus, if you're looking in the mirror and you're making videos like these, it just makes your biceps look huge. So always a bonus. Anyway, we're down in weight a little bit. We go to 25 pounds and we try and do 16 of these. So here we go. I love this thing. If you're gonna go out and buy one piece of equipment, get this. Oh, everyone works their biceps too much anyway, so might as well have one of these. We are doing one-arm corkscrew curls. So anyway, pronated palm grip, pronated position. We're gonna twist them around one at a time. I like to call these old man curls. If you go to any gym, you'll find some old man sitting there. But that's not exactly what we're doing. Here we go. I realized while I was doing, because I speed up the video, that probably does look like old man. All right, up next, chin-ups, reverse grip pull-up. Must be getting tired. Reverse grip pull-ups, I'm gonna try and do 12. Bent over back flies. I think I say it every single time, but I have horrible flexibility through my hips, and so the bent over part looks pretty bad. But we're still trying to do a bent over back fly, and this is as good as it gets for now. So here we go. Up more curls. I think we're supposed to do a curl up, hammer down, and then I think just hammer curls. I've been using 30 pounds all day, and then in the past we were doing 30 pounds too, but our form is just getting ugly today. Arms are a little tired, whatever. So we're actually gonna go down in weight. We're gonna go down to 25 pounds today and try and correct our form a little bit here. So anyway, someone driving by. Anyway, never bad to go down in weight. Always want to have good form. So for me, more important form than like glory lifting or, you know, just pure weight for with horrible form. Anyway, here we go. Up hammer curls. I'm gonna stick to keeping a lighter weight. That felt really good actually with the curl up hammer downs. It was still really tough, but I was able to slow down a little bit and keep really good form. So still felt like I was getting the same pump. Again, next, just straight hammer curls. And we're gonna, again, go down to 25 pounds. So was doing 30 last week, got 12 of them. We're gonna go down to 25 and try and get the full 16. Here we go. pull-ups. I think this is the last set of pull-ups. Oh, you get to choose whichever grip you want. A lot of times I go with the neutral grip. That's my easiest. I don't know what I want to do today. Maybe today we'll do switch. I don't know, though, if I can do 12 of those, but we'll try. So we're going to do wide, narrow, reverse, and neutral. We're going to try for three of each. Oh, that's ambitious. Let's go for it. Last back exercise. We're done with the rows and the pull-ups. And this is a cable row, just a good old-fashioned cable row. So palms down, pronated grip, pulling right into the chest. We're gonna try and sit up nice and tall, keeping a neutral spine, all that good stuff. And we're gonna go for 16 of them. We got 110 on the plates. Here we go. Two more moves. We got in and out, hammer curls. So we're gonna come up, we're gonna come out. Again, we're gonna go down in weight. We had 30 pounds last week. We're only gonna do 10 of them, which is fine if we wanna be bulking up right away. But again, we're just trying to keep lightweight, good form for a couple more weeks, and then we'll start going up in weight. So anyway, that's the master plan. But today, hammer curls. And then after that, we have a strip set. We'll keep our weight up in that one. Because that's kind of the whole point of that set. But we start at 30 pounds. We keep going down in either 2.5 or 5 pound increments, depending on what weights I have, down to 15 pounds. So you'll see that next. First up, hammer curls. So we're gonna do that right now. Let's go. Comes the very last set, strip set. So again, we're gonna start with 30 pounds. We're gonna try and knock out 10 of those. Go down to 25 pounds, and we just keep increasing our reps while decreasing our weight until we get down to 15 pounds. Good workout today. So the last move. Here we go. Just gives me such a forearm pump. Oh, I mean, my biceps definitely feel it too, but by the end, when I'm on those 15 pounders, just my forearms feel like they're gonna explode. Anyway, finished another workout, day 12. Whew, the body transformation series. We are down to 173 pounds. Oh, when we woke up this morning, today was back and biceps. Thank you very much for watching. Always appreciate it. I hope you enjoyed the video. Oh, if you did enjoy the video, or you plan on trying any of these workouts, or even just coming back tomorrow to check it out again, please go ahead and hit the like button. Give me a thumbs up. If you haven't done it already, please subscribe to my channel. Ho, Square One Fitness. Whew, on YouTube. You can look me up on Facebook, Square One Fitness. Facebook.com. We're putting out a video every single day of my body transformation. We're trying to lose all this body fat, put on a little muscle, bulk up. We're going to do that in 60 to 90 days. Like I said, putting out a video every single day. Oh, your subscriptions really do help not only motivate me, but grow my channel. And they do not go unappreciated. I wanted to say one last time, thank you, Leo, hashtag, for subscribing. Oh, thank you, everybody, for watching today. I hope you enjoyed the video. Come back tomorrow. We got our weekend workout. We switch that up. It's a little different every weekend. And then Sunday will be our off day, but we'll post a small video on that day, too, of our progress, our weight, and just keeping everybody up to date. So one last time, thank you for watching. Everybody have a great day. Be sure to get some exercise and eat healthy, and I'll see you guys later. Bam.